I'm very happy to be back in Brazil. I'm currently in São Paulo talking about what we can do to apply some of the findings we get from brain research, how we can apply that to what we do in the classrooms. My first tip would be thinking is not a natural function like sleeping, walking, eating, or talking. People do not necessarily become wiser as they become older. They only do if they train their brain, which means for us that we need to help students develop their thinking skills. We need to help them develop their basic and later their critical thinking capabilities. The brain is concerned with helping us to survive. It rewards us for understanding and not simply for getting answers right. This means we need the right level of challenge for our students, just like in Goldilocks. Not too little and not too much. The brain's interested in content that's relevant for the students' future lives. Therefore, we need to use topic and texts that engage students emotionally and cognitively so we can get them to explore values and think about real life issues. Teens seem so cool, especially when they are amongst their peer group. But deep down, they're often insecure. Let's make sure we help students develop their self-esteem, their sense of self-worth, by creating a classroom culture that each and every student wants to belong to. Engaging students in small talk is an efficient way of showing them that we respect them and we are interested in them as people.